Lovely people, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna play with a foolish face of Huda Beauty makeup. I bought some last year in the Black Friday sale and this year in Black Friday sale, and it already came. So I figured I'd do a foolish face of everything I've got and see what I liked and how it works and if it works on my skin, because I've got at the moment quite some dry patches on my around my mouth. So I'm really curious how the Huda Beauty holds up to that, because I have this Huda Beauty foundation since last year. It's not the new one, because the new one wasn't on sale and it was too expensive, so sorry, I just have this one. And I'm wondering if it, because they say it's not good on dry skin, so I'm gonna try it. I do use this occasionally, I do like it, it's nothing wrong with it, it has a good smell to it. If you don't like perfume in foundation, then don't buy it, but yeah. And I finally got myself the right color concealer. I already had the cookie dough, which is too dark for me, and now I got coconut flakes in this sale. So I've checked it, it's the good color for me. So that's what we're gonna try out. Then I bought the new lipstick. This is in the color Wedding Day. This gorgeous nude color, which we're gonna put on today. And I'm gonna use it with my Trophy White lip contour. This already bought in a kit before, and this was last year for the Black Friday sale. And then I've got finally got a Tantour, which I really really wanted. I've got the color light, and I'm normally in foundation a medium, but I don't know, I thought the medium one was too dark for me. So there's an extra lid on it, and this is the color, which looks quite good, I think. So we'll see. So I hope it's gonna be okay. I figured the lighter one would be smarter than a darker one. I've got the powder, which I bought again last year in the thing, which I like. Last year in the Black Friday sale, so that's all right. And I got my new palettes. I have the Desert Dust and the new nude, which is already on my channel. So if you want to see videos from those, then just check them out. There's also a little shorts with the Desert Dusk, so check it out if you like looks with the beauty palettes. They're on my channel. And today we're gonna use the Mercury Retrograde, which is for me a new palette. I've never used this before. This is the colors, which, oh, I love with the beauty palettes. They're, ooh, some ASMR. I have not seen this. Oh, that sounds amazing. Putting this all on my face. So if you enjoy that and want to see it, then please subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell, give me a like and a comment if you want to, or if you want to see new, or you want to see me play again with different palettes or try different eye looks. Always contact me in my comments, I will react to every single one of them, and we'll see what we can do. And let's just start. I have my Rise and Pride my face. I'm gonna start with my foundation. So we're gonna start with the Faux Filter High Coverage foundation. And this is in the color Macaroon 230N. And just let's put this all over my face. So yeah, I do use my high coverage, my high-end foundations. I just don't use as much as my drugstore ones. Cause, yeah, I don't know, I just always think it's just a shame. Oh. Well, that's too light for me. I use it recently, yeah. Well, this is light, but not as light. I think it's lighter than my face, but not as quite okay with my neck, I think. Let's just put it all over, like you can see, full coverage. Just went over all my spots instantly, my redness on my face. And this is a high perfume one, so you have a lot of perfume in it, you smell it. I don't mind it. I have eczema, and yeah, I don't, this doesn't irritate me at all. I just smell it, it doesn't feel like where it's happening on my face. Yeah, like I said, dry patches around my mouth, so if you see any there, that's why. They're already there. I'm putting a lot of cream on it, but it's because the weather is changing here in the Netherlands and getting colder, so of course my skin reacts to that. It is just what it is. Let's hope The breakouts will stop because it's color. That was very shite. Yeah, look at the coverage, people. It's clinging to my dry patches, but then again, I've tried a couple of hydrating foundations lately from the drugstore and they all did it. I'm again gonna use my BH Cosmetics number 8 brush from the Studio Pro line and just put some extra foundation, which I still have foundation pellets, a little bit. A spot where I think I need it. I always put extra on my nose because I don't know. I always feel if I don't do that, it will cover my nose. But actually, I did like the coverage, it wasn't that bad. But sometimes you just need a little extra. Now the color seems okay with my neck, I think. Or is it? Yeah, I don't know. Looks really nice on my mirror, but when I look in my mirror behind my camera, I don't know. Then I'm gonna go in with the Tintur and Light. I'm going in with my contour. It looks face paint brush, this is Jessup 109. Step it in, yeah, and let's see. Don't want to go too dark yet. We'll use it. I normally use my contour here, here, here and here, and then a little, sometimes a little bit under my nose and everything. I just never use it there. I always use a bronzer there, which I don't have, of course, from Huda, but I have one from the Primark. I'll see. Let's just try it. Could be a little more cool tone for me, I think, but it's not. I'm happy I bought the light one and not the dark one, I think. A little bit there. A little bit there, guess why not. Blend it in with my sponge. Is that what I normally do with cream contour? It's got really nice into the skin, I think. Yeah. I didn't go ham, like you can see. I like that. So I'm gonna put on my bronzer and a blusher, cream blush, and I'll be right back. So I did everything in the wrong order. I always do contour normally and then I should have gone in with my concealer instead of with my blush. Because now my blush is on, it's gonna be gone, so we're gonna do it again. So if everything goes wrong, that's why. So we're going in with my Overachiever concealer, and this is the color Coconut Flakes 10N. And this has come with some silvery thingy. This should be really good for puffiness because it should be cooling. Oh, that's nice. Oh, that's really cold. Okay. Don't mind that. Yeah, I'm gonna cover, unfortunately, all of my blush. Yeah, that's all we're gonna put on. I don't want too much to ruin my blush. Let me just blend this in and see. Oh, this is a nice color. I think at least not too light, but just a little bit. Well, you can see I'm covering all the blush up. Oh well. But Because I feel if I do my... Not that bad. Contour first and then my concealer, it matches better, mix in better. And if you do your concealer less, it's gonna be cracked before I even get it, and then I have to push it back in, and that annoys me. So that's why I wanted to do it at the end, but didn't think of the blush. Because yeah, when you're doing makeup, I just get all into it and just don't think and just have fun. It's actually not bad when I see this. The blush is here permanent, but just a little bit less. I don't mind it this way, actually. Blends out nicely. And I don't mind it like this, with the first and then the blush. Now we're gonna go in my Huda Beauty powder in color Pound Cake. I love this. It's good powder. Nothing wrong with it. Don't like the netting that's in it on the first bits, because it has a lid on it, but there was powder on top of it, so I just took that off with my brush at the moment. And I do use this more than I do the foundation, to be really honest. Yeah, the color looks good, doesn't it? When I look so at my neck, yeah. This powder, like you can see, has a netting in it. And I don't know. Sometimes I like it, sometimes it annoys me. I always do my under eyes with a smaller brush so I get in the corner so that there won't be any creasing. That's why I like doing my concealer not too long before I do my powder. That's a smaller brush, and let's go in with my big brush. The contour is really nice. I think I got the right color to make it nice and subtle, not too much. See, that's it. So here's my base on, and I really like it. Looks good. Yeah, and again, it's dry around the mouth. It will be dry no matter what foundation I use, so yeah. I will finish my face, my base, with concealer, with more bronzer, contour and everything. And then we'll be back when I'm gonna do my eyes. My face is done. Just did a little bit of highlight, blush, everything. I've put an eye base on down on my eyes. And now we're gonna go in with the gorgeous palette. So this one, which is called Hot Mess. We're just gonna start with that one. So we're gonna pack this with my E42 from Sigma on my outer corner to see how dark this is. And let's hope it doesn't have too much fallout, because like always, I've done my face first, because I don't know, I just love doing my face first. I have to do my face first. It's a good no-go for me to go another way. Yeah, that looks like the same color as in the pan. I hope it's the same formula as all her other big palettes, because I like it. I'm gonna go not too extreme today, because I've done extreme looks recently, at least long videos. I've done neutral looks on my shorts, so I figured let's do a neutral look on a long video. If the shorts annoy you, then please tell me. But yeah, it is very good. It's very good for my views and wash hours lately, so I like to keep doing it and using it. But that means that you do get a video 6 days a week, because that's what I want to try. I want to do Monday, Thursday and Saturday my main videos. And Sunday, Tuesday, and Friday, my shorts, and then Wednesday it's gonna be nothing on my channel, one day off. I think that's what I wanna do, so as long as I have the time for it, I'll keep doing it. I hope I get a lot prepared. I'm making two videos today, so, but those are two main videos. Yeah, that color looks beautiful. Went really nicely on there. Yeah, I like it. We're gonna go in with Off Balance, which is this mauve color up here. This one. And we're gonna do this all again with my Sigma Detail Blending Brush, and this is the E27. It's a flat brush. See, and it's already stained because I've been using it a lot recently. Let's see what this color does. So yeah, I want to keep constant with my videos because I do notice that if I keep creating on regular days that my subscriber count is going up. I just hit 150 yesterday, which is amazing, another milestone. And I hope I can continue it and keep doing it and keep enjoying it. And we'll see what happens. Ooh, that's a beautiful color. Nice and pinky. Is it a neutral look, right? But this also always ends up being more than just neutral. So I do wonder, what do you guys think of Huda Beauty? Do you like it? Do you use from it? Do you buy from it? Like I said, I've only actually mostly bought anything from them for on sales, to be really honest, because I think it's expensive. But I do like to try, because the palette just cost me now 33 euros. And normally the palettes from Huda are about 60. So yeah. Kind of love it. But I do really like her formula and everything, because this foundation looks really nice on my skin. Yes, you can see the dry patches around my mouth, but yeah, basically any foundation would do that. Maybe a little less with a glowy foundation, but then again I always put powder on it, because I don't know, I feel like if I don't put powder on it, it just disappears so fast, my makeup. But maybe that's just me. Oh, those colors work really well together, blend nicely, look good. So yeah, to keep going on my train of thought, do you like Huda Beauty? Do you buy from them? Do you use stuff? Nine palettes as well, but I don't have any of those, because again, money. And I wanted to get for Christmas, but we couldn't get it where I wanted it to get. I'm gonna go in with this one, called Momentum, light one. Just to blend it out and make it a little bit softer. And I'm using a Sigma again today, apparently. This is E45, but then again, I'm using an expensive palette, so why not use expensive brushes? I do really like these Sigma brushes, so maybe I'm gonna invest in a little bit more of them, but we'll see. But yeah. I like Huda stuff, it's just expensive. And this, I don't know if the new foundation is not as bad thick of coverage as this one. I do like my coverage, to be really honest. I don't know. Do you, and everyone, just do you put powder on top of your makeup? Or do you just leave it wet sometimes? Because I never do that. I never go. I always put powder on top. Even though I have drier to normal to dry skin. I think so. So would that be a smart idea? I like it. And so a little bit lighter pink. Let's go back in with Off Balance. The second shade I used, just a little bit more, and a little bit more of Hot Mess, the darker shade. I'm gonna keep it natural, so I'm going in with the I'm going in with Cosmic in the inner corner and then leave it into no. So I press it back in. Went okay. You'll still see it, but oh well. I managed to save everything. So first in with Cosmic. So first in Cosmic and then Supernova. And with the same brushes, did you know that's not true? I have two of these. This is the 237 from Jessup. And I have another one which I just used. Oh, this is a different formula? I will see. Also not gonna cut my crease because I want to keep it nice and soft. Just for once, give the neutrals, because I do like my neutrals. I just enjoy more playing with makeup and doing extreme looks. It's just more me, more, yeah. But wow. And I'll definitely do more looks with this as well, because this already has a little bit of the other color Supernova on it, because I just press it in with it again. Again, this is the 237. I have two of these because I bought two Jessup sets because those are amazing. Oh wow. Oh, look at that. That's pretty. That is pretty. Let's blend it in together. That's more foily than the first one, I think. I think the first one's more of a shimmery shade. That's probably a different formula. First one, I think. This one is also a little bit more buttery. But happy I could save it. It's a beautiful shade though. So yeah, I would like to do a little bit more of a mixture of extreme and a little bit normal looks. But do you like it when I do just different kind of eye looks, some extreme, some less extreme? I'm going back in with Cosmic to blend this together. Or do you want to just do an extreme, or do you think like this when I do a try on, just do a simplistic look and just do an extreme look when it's just one palette? Or I don't know, I do like this look. Oh, it's pretty though. Because yeah, my shorts, like I said, are more neutral looks, because I think I can get more viewers with those in the shorts, because yeah, the people that already follow me of course also like the extreme eye looks. I think going back in with the color Hot Mess on my E42 and blend this together. So yeah, what do you like? Because yeah, I would like to do a mixture, so I think I'm gonna do it anyway, because yeah, it's my channel. Let's be real. Because I always like to have advice and see what other people think. And I do notice that my friends here in the Netherlands that I didn't know for years are more into neutral. Because every time I post a neutral pic on Facebook or Instagram, they always go, oh, I like this on you. And then I always think, yeah, I like it. I just also like the extreme looks. And I will walk out of the door with extreme looks just as much as I will go out with this look. Because, yeah, I like it. Ooh. Yeah. Let's do the lower lash line with the same color. So first in again with Hot Mess. And I'm using the same brushes because I'm using smaller brushes. So I think I can pull this off by putting this. So yeah, like I said, all tips and everything are welcome. Please let me know what you want, what you think. I wanna, but I have so many ideas and film things in my head at the moment, and so many new makeup coming in because I bought way too much that's what I want to try and want to play with. So and I don't know how to pick a challenge. Like, if I do a palette bingo, which palette do I use? Do I just let my sister pick colors, or do I just go and put it in a generator, and which generator should I use then? And oh, so many things to think about if you want to do challenges and everything. And then you have to, of course, post people that have done the same, and of course it's not an original idea, but it's an idea. It's good to have a lot of ideas about it, I think, at least, and see what's gonna happen. So yeah, that's kind of a good neutral eye, but pinky. I like it. I'm gonna finish the rest of my face, and then we only have to do my lips together, so I'll be back when I'm done for ready for my lips. So yeah, that's my brows on, my lashes on. I went a little bit extreme on the lashes compared to my eyes, because these are huge. This is the His Beauty Aria lash, which I got on a nice glitch discount. Yeah, done my brows, and now I just have to do my lips. And yeah, I think my lashes are really extreme for this look, but who cares, they're on there. I'm not gonna take them off, because then I have to take my makeup off. And my eye is watering, which is really annoying. Can you see this? Look. So that's really annoying me, which is just more often than I want. Which really annoys me, and it's only this eye, and just this outer corner. And I keep putting eyeshadow on it, because it annoys me to death, but well. It's what it is. Yeah. I did that, so I'm gonna go in with my Trophy Wife lip contour lip liner. I've used this more than you can see. I've already sharpened it occasionally when I needed to. Let's see. That's the lip contour on. So like I said, I have the matching lipstick and everything, but these are the newest ones she have launched, if I'm correct. And I really want to try if it works and if it's nice on my lips. There's quite a lot in it, it's normal. I do like the form of this, because I already have one in metallic. This is Cake Day, and I really like the shape of it, to be honest. Let's see. And this is in the color Wedding Day, for anyone wants to know. Ooh, that's really comfy. Ooh, yeah, that looks nice. Yeah, I like it. Yeah. So, that's my full face of Huda Beauty finished. Yeah. I think it looks amazing on my skin. I look quite flawless at the moment. I love it. The eyes came out amazing. I like the colors on the palette. I will try the palette again with other colors, and then just do a voiceover just for the palette to see what else I can create with it. But yeah, it's good. Could I have achieved this with the new nudes? Maybe. It doesn't have this dark of a purple, I think. But yeah. There's so many dip palettes in the world. They're gonna be a little bit overlapping. But yeah, I really like it. I do. I'm sorry, I'm positive again. But then again, I already had the foundation, so I knew that. And my under eyes are looking really nice with the powder and the foundation as well. And the concealer is amazing. So yeah, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel. Hit that like button, hit the notifications bell, make a comment, do it, please. I had a lot of fun. I hope you had fun too, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!